In this lesson, you'll be introduced to the Excel workbook environment. In these tutorials, we will be using Excel 2007 and the Windows 7 operating system, but the topics we will cover will apply to other versions of Excel and Windows as well. You can open Excel by clicking on the Start menu icon in the lower left corner of the screen. Then select Programs, Microsoft Office, and Excel. You are looking at the Excel workbook environment. This environment consists of many worksheets. By default, three blank worksheets are created for you. You can create more worksheets by clicking on the Insert Worksheet tab at the bottom of the screen. You can zoom in and zoom out of a worksheet by clicking on the plus and minus button at the lower right corner of the screen. Each worksheet consists of many cells. Each cell has an address consisting of a column letter and a row number. For example, cell B3 is located in the second column, which is labeled B, and the third row. Data can be entered and manipulated in these cells. You can enter data into a cell by selecting a cell, then typing a number in that cell and hitting enter. Let's enter some numbers into cells B2 through E2. The number 3 is entered into cell B2. The number 5 is entered into cell C2. The number -2 is entered into D2. And the number 7 is entered into cell E2. The data stored in cells may be used to perform mathematical calculations elsewhere in the worksheet. We can access the data stored in a particular cell by typing that cell's column letter and row number. For example, in cell B4, let's type the formula equals B2 plus 5 and hit enter. The value in B2, which is 3 at the moment, is added to 5 and the resulting value 8 is displayed in B4. Although the number 8 appears in cell B4, it is important to remember that the value that appears in B4 really is the value in B2 plus 5. If the value in B2 were to become 10, the value in B4 would change to 15. The formula bar at the top of the spreadsheet displays the formula associated with the selected cell. When writing formulas, it is important to remember that you must include an equal sign at the beginning of the formula. The dash symbol is used for subtraction. In cell B5, let's type equals D2 minus 1 and hit enter. The value in D2, which is -2 at the moment, has 1 subtracted from it, and the resulting value, -3, is displayed in B5. The asterisk symbol is used for multiplication. You can type an asterisk by holding the Shift key while typing the number 8. In cell D4, let's type equals C2 asterisk D2 and hit enter. The value in C2, which is 5 at the moment, is multiplied by the value in D2, which is -2 at the moment. The resulting value, -10, is displayed in D4. The front slash symbol is used for division. In cell E4, let's type equals C2 divided by, or front slash, D2, and hit enter. The value in C2, which is 5 at the moment, is divided by the value in D2, which is -2 at the moment. The resulting value, -2.5, is displayed in E4. The caret symbol is used for exponents. You can type a caret, which looks like an up arrow, by holding the shift key while typing the number 6. In cell F4, let's type equals E2 caret 2 and hit enter. The value in E2, which is 7 at the moment, is raised to the second power. The resulting value, 49, is displayed in F4. For very large or very small numbers, it may be more convenient to use scientific notation. If you want to type the number 2 billion into cell A1, you can type 2 followed by 9 zeros. Or 2E9. If you want to type the number 3 billionths, you can type 0.00000003 or 3E-9. You can also enter text into a cell. Type "Hi everyone" into cell C1. You can save the data stored in an Excel workbook by clicking on the Office button and choosing the Save option. I name my Excel file and save it on the desktop. If you're using Excel 2007 or later, the default extension for an Excel file is .xlsx. Later, when we create programs called macros, we will be saving Excel workbooks with a .xlsm extension. When I close the Excel file and reopen it, the data is preserved.